7. 8.
Oh! That was brutal.
Today we're going to be simulating two motorcycle crashes. We're going to do one with a helmet and then another without. Trying anyway. I spent my own money and got several of these skulls from Ballistics Dummy Lab. It has what I would assume pretty realistic weight. Pretty good. We have confirmed accuracy. This is the helmet we got. This is a DOT approved helmet. It was about 60 bucks. I found it on Amazon. And I did debate whether or not I should go with a DOT approved or something higher like a Snell. But I hope we can at least prove even basic safety equipment is better than no safety equipment whatsoever. One big complaint that I have about this helmet has this type of buckle strap, and I don't like those. These tend to come loose. Yeah, we got a real hog.
And I'm a professional two-wheel rider. You can get the size and the height off the road and get everything perfect, scientifically accurate.
I feel like this is a little bit lower than your average motorcycle. Focus right there. That's doable. We're gonna be putting a balaclava on the helmet, not for any sort of safety reasons, but the ballistics gel is kind of tacky and I can't get the helmet to slide on without it. Here, hold it down. Wrap her in. Oh, let's
can't
get
see
this.
Very well.
There we go.
There you go.
All right. Dude's ready.
Let's call him Clip. Clip. The top got clipped off.
Clippy's going first. What's the other one going to be called?
I don't know, Splat.
I got Clip. Call it out to me. You know, let's get 50 over the crest. Go from there.
All right, dude, if you're ready.
Yeah, send it. Down the highway. It's a bloodbath. Oh, poor guy. Man, that's some good road rash.
The spine, have the jaws all road rashed up.
I feel like we did the no helmet drop already. Do we have a skull fracture?
That's a hemorrhage right there.
How did,
it's like came from down here and worked its way.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's definitely, look at the whole, right
Oh, solid impact right there. Under the right care, the right health insurance, he might make it. Oh, we need to watch the slow-mo. You gonna see your work.
Whoa, the flex.
Fair. I mean, your spine would have to, like your head would have to come off from your body for this to happen. I really didn't do a good job dropping. I think this was the first hit, but I think when I let it go, it kind of went down that way. We landed right on the buckle for one, and this is why you don't use this type of buckle. These things are just crap. This poor guy. If this doesn't turn inside out, I'm gonna be shocked.
I'm looking forward to that first impact.
Yeah.
In slow-mo. Aim the face towards the camera.
I'm gonna try. I didn't do very good on that first one. I'm gonna try to get a Let's roll.
Yo! Let's go!
We got a lot to clean up on that one.
Oh, there it is. There it is.
Oh!
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 Gosh.
Please don't demonetize me.
Looks like someone hit a hog out here.
So we got our first hit, probably about halfway between us and the car. So that's like 30, 20 yards. Oh my gosh. Look, the bone is on the outside. How did this happen? The bone is on the outside. It's a clean cut. All right. So there is a lot to unpack here. First, let's look at Clip. He was inside the helmet. And I honestly think that about 95% of the damage that we're seeing on him came after the head came out of the helmet, after the buckle failed, which is what happened. The buckle came loose. There was plenty of chin purchase. He was ratcheted in there really good. Like I said at the start of the video, these little like rollerblade buckle straps, I just don't like them because they fail. As we saw, they can fail if they're hit just right or even if they're stressed too hard. If you have to get something cheap, be sure that it is not approved, and I would really recommend the D-ring style strap clips. I do this every time. I don't know what this is. The helmet actually did pretty good. It absorbed the blow. You could see it flex, which was awesome. That's what it's designed to do, absorb that impact. And it rolled down the street for like 50, 60 yards, and it wasn't until like the last 5-10 yards that the head actually came out. By comparison, I would say the argument for wearing a helmet is pretty strong. I know it looks like a lot, there's actually two heads. I bought three, two for this video and one I was hoping to do for another video next week. The first drop, which didn't end up being in the video because I actually dropped it out of frame, so I had to do it again. This is splat two, this is the one that we did see in the video. It's dramatic. All of that impact, everything went into the head, the skull, which is not designed to do. This was splat one. It actually was pretty spectacular itself. This is the top of him. I thought that this had somehow been inside and then wrapped around to the outside. It's not. This is the top of the skull, and this is the brain. I'm done. I'm hoping this video doesn't get demonetized. I want this channel to grow, and I think these type of videos are good for people. You can support this channel with, I have a Patreon. I don't really talk about it. I do have merch, link down below. I don't really talk about those things because I feel weird about that. Thank you for the new subscribers. Thank you for watching these videos and sharing them, talking about them, commenting on them. You know, and I would really appreciate it if you would.